Today, we're going to be looking at the gaming performance offered by a 13-inch MacBook Pro. The model used for this episode is a maxed out MacBook Pro 13-inch from 2018. All these games have been played on a 27-inch 1080p monitor. Our first game to benchmark is Katana Zero. This is a new platform game, and it is very well optimized for Mac. On both macOS and Windows 10, it can run at 1080p Mac settings with an average FPS of 60. Katana Zero is the best example of the type of games you should play on 13-inch MacBook Pros. This would be games that don't have advanced 3D graphics, but instead have 2D graphics. Next up, we have the best action-adventure game on Mac, Rise of the Tomb Raider. This game can work on all 13-inch MacBook Pros from 2016 and up. However, you should only be able to play it well at 720p low settings with 20 to 40 FPS, depending on your model's hardware. My model runs it at 1280 by 720 at the low quality preset and hits 36.6 FPS under macOS, and under Windows, it hits around 34.47 FPS. By the way, I ran this benchmark many times, and macOS always won by only a few frames. Games like this one should really be played on Macs which offer dedicated graphics, such as 15-inch MacBook Pros or the iMac series. Fortnite. Fortnite is not very well optimized for Macs with integrated graphics cards. Under macOS, it runs for me at 1080p, medium settings, and hits 30 FPS. And under Windows, it hits around 35 FPS. This isn't terrible, but Fortnite should be played at 40 frames per second, really 60 frames and over for the best experience. Next up, we have the most popular MOBA, Dota 2. Dota 2 is a 2013 game, but it has recently received the Vulkan API support, and it's running like a charm under macOS when compared to running on the previous OpenGL API. For example, it can run at 1080p medium settings and gets close to 50 FPS under macOS, whilst under Windows 10, we are receiving around 40 FPS with the Vulkan API. Isn't that strange? Anyone else surprised? Next, we have the latest macOS racing game, Dirt 4. This game was only recently released on Mac in early 2019. Under both macOS and Windows 10, I am running the game at 1600 by 900 medium settings and receiving an average FPS of 33. Dirt 4 is supported on all 13-inch MacBook Pros released from 2016 and up, but the game can actually work on all models ranging back to mid-2012. All should be able to receive at least 30 FPS or over, but don't count me on that. 30 FPS is not amazing these days, but for a racing game, 30 frames per second is just fine, in my opinion anyway. Up next, we have the RPG game Divinity Original Sin 2. Released for Mac in early 2019, this is the best RPG on Mac today. It supports all 13-inch MacBook Pros released from late 2016 and up. I'm running it at 1600 by 900 medium settings and receiving about 35 FPS under both macOS and Windows 10. Our last game is Black Ops 3. So Black Ops 3 was only recently ported to Mac, and it's actually not supported for 13-inch MacBook Pros, as this game requires a Mac with an AMD graphics card. So for example, running it on my machine, it plays at 1280 by 720 resolution, low settings, and sees around 45 FPS. It's playable, but it doesn't look very nice. However, the reason why I'm sharing this game with you is because new MacBook Pros from 2016 or later support Thunderbolt 3. This means you can connect an external graphics card for improved gaming performance. For instance, I'm using an EGFX Breakaway box and RX 560 GPU card. This allows me to play at 1080p high settings with an average FPS of 60. If you want to play demanding games on low-end Macs, I highly suggest that you invest in an external GPU. It's kind of life-saving. So, what can we take from all this? 13-inch MacBook Pros are not terrible for gaming, but they do have their setbacks when it comes to playing high-end demanding games. Because they have integrated graphics cards, you can't expect much from them in terms of gaming. Installing Windows 10 via Bootcamp should increase performance and overall frames per second, but don't expect a major difference. These 13-inch MacBook Pros should really be used to play 2D games, indie games, or older titles. Anyway, if you found this video useful, leave a like and subscribe, as coming soon, we'll be looking at benchmarking the new iMac Retina 4K 21.5-inch from 2019. Anyway, thanks for watching. Bye-bye.